Hello everyone, this is Veronica and today we are going to talk about a very serious issue about a dirty river, that is Yamuna, and what are the effects of drugs that are recently being discharged into Yamuna. We'll discuss about them. So for my video updates, you can follow me on Instagram, and for the PDF of this lecture, that will be uploaded on my Facebook profile. So this is a channel, StudyIQ. If you're preparing for any government exam, our pen drive and tablet courses are also available. For additional information, you can visit our website or you can call on the numbers given on the screen. So what is the relevance of this topic? So for the objective level questions, drugs mentioned in the lecture are very important. They could be asked in the subjective level. What are the sources of water pollution? What is the crisis faced by India and how it can be toned down? On that, you can get a question, and as well as you can write about it in essay also. So why is in news? As you know, Yamuna, around 22 drains flow into the Yamuna in Delhi. So this is one fact that you should know. And Delhi has made no efforts to check pollution in Najafgarh drain basin. Najafgarh is a place in Delhi that comes in southwest Delhi. Okay. So we'll talk about it. Now just see why is it is in news, because a recent study reveals the effects of discharge of drugs containing effluents into Yamuna. So this is what it is being revealed by a study. Now discharge of drug containing effluents can cause drug resistance. See how. First of all, human body does not use entire quantity of drug when it is taken. Then what happened? Most of it is excreted and thus end up in aquatic systems, right? From where the drugs, the question is, from where the drugs went into the river. So obviously it's from the human body, because most of it is excreted usually, but it whatever is not excreted ends up in aquatic system via domestic sewage. Now the study thus looks at the occurrence, fate and ecological risks of these compounds. So it is observed that 9 different pharmaceutical active compounds in the Yamuna river, they found it. So these pharmaceutical active compounds can possibly cause chronic toxicity to the aquatic life and as well as to the humans who use this water, right? Now, the researchers of IIT Delhi and National Mission for Clean Ganga collected these water samples from at least 6 sites across the river, around 25 kilometer river area they used, and they collected the water in different seasons, like from November 2010 to April, July 2011. So, using different extraction processes, the pharmaceutical residues in the water were recovered and analyzed. So, they recovered and analyzed all this data, all these samples they had. So see what they have analyzed, what are the findings of the research. There are 6 over-the-counter drugs, like aspirin was there, paracetamol was there, ibuprofen, ranitidine was there, diclofenac, and there are 3 prescription drugs also, including codeine and diazepam. And even the concentration they made out, ibuprofen and paracetamol have the high concentration in the water, and it is given here. So these are the findings of the research. Now the highest concentration of pharmaceutical compounds was located downstream Wazirabad. Wazirabad is an area in Delhi. So Wazirabad, at the point where Najafgarh drain joins the Yamuna. So main problem starts when the Najafgarh drain joins in the Yamuna. This is one of the largest drains of Delhi and has an average discharge of around 25 cubic meters per second. 25 cubic meter per second. This drain is the largest polluter of the river, contributing more than 50% of total discharge into Yamuna. Now at this site, some particular drugs like ibuprofen and paracetamol, as I told you, they have the highest concentration. Now there are previous studies which have shown that even small concentration of these drugs can have very bad and devastating effects on the aquatic organisms, and they can even cause algal bloom. So that is cyanobacterial growth in the river, which will affect the other aquatic life, other aquatic organisms in the water. Okay, now even caffeine was found in high concentration in these sites, and caffeine is used as a stimulant in medicine. From where it came, caffeine came from medicines and obviously from the beverages coffee you are having daily. So that is also main contributor to the pollution of Yamuna. And even this drug was having the highest level of concentration, that is 1.35 microgram per liter, right? So Yamuna is getting dirty day by day. And there are various sources of pollution actually. There is water pollution, there is domestic pollution, then there is air pollution. So everything is harming this river. Now, what are the hazards? Obviously, to the marine life and to the people who are using the water from the river. And we need more studies on these pharmaceutical active components, because they are the emerging problem in our country. And we need to sensitize the government about this problem, because they not only affect the biodiversity, this is one thing which will definitely get affected, but then some other problems like rise of superbugs. Superbugs are the multi-resistant drug bacteria or microorganisms against which the medicines won't work, because they are already getting exposed to these medical medicines, these drugs. So they become superbugs. They don't get affected by these medicines when they are needed in the human population. So what is the way forward? See, uncontrolled discharge of drug containing effluents in our rivers and other water bodies can potentially make microbes drug resistant, I told you. So we need some kind of regulations over these discharges. This is a serious problem. Maybe right now we don't realize how big this problem could be, but later on, if an epidemic suppose falls out and no drugs is working out against a particular disease, then we will realize the depth of this problem. Even our sewage treatment plants design is not good, because what we are doing, the treated waste we are throwing in Yamuna, the untreated waste we are throwing in the rivers. And obviously there are no guidelines or specific rules in place about this that need to become for the way forward. And government needs to take a note of out of this, as this would be the first step from the government side if they bring some guidelines and rules regulating this kind of process. So this study highlights the need for the government to bring in the guidelines or specific rules to arrest and address this problem, right? So this is a very important topic. If you have any queries, you can ask me, and for the PDF of this lecture, you can contact me on Telegram channel. Thank you.